Rory Gallagher.
So these couple of kids come up, who's me and my mate, and say, you know, how do you get your sound, Mr. Gallagher? And he sits and tells us, so I owe Rory my sound.
One of the things that was crucial for me, I got from Rory Gallagher, was the idea of, like, being a guitar player for life and living it, and it being your calling and like, a vocation, really, and it being the most important thing in your life.
Without Rory Gallagher, would Brian May have found the Queen guitar sound? Would Johnny Marr have been the guitar player he is? They don't think so. And how would I have fared as I set off on my journey in music? I'm Gary Moore, and this is the Rory Gallagher story.
There's no doubt that he was one of the greatest guitar players we've ever produced.
He embodied honesty to me in the way of playing music and in his life. You know.
Such a fine musician, and Rory's integrity was always intact. And he followed his talent rather than following what some record company told him to do.
People absolutely loved it. And so why do I say that in the past tense? People love Rory.
Rory Gallagher always ploughed his own furrow, touring constantly, turning his back on chances of commercial success to pursue his own music. So expect to hear elements of folk and jazz, ragtime and R&B in what he did, but especially the blues.
The guy was one of the best guitar players in the world, you know, I mean, and you're on stage working with this guy, you know, it's got to make you feel good.
It was a natural habitat for him, you know, just to go on stage with a rave audience.
Seeing him live was quite an eye-opener, particularly if you were very young, because it was bordering on terrifying, really, in its intensity.
Was a teenage Brian May.
I can remember the On the Boards album being on the turntable almost constantly. On the Boards is probably the most special album for me of Rory's. I think it's the rawness, the feeling that you're actually seeing him there in front of you. It doesn't feel processed, and you can feel the sweat.
I was dabbling in with jazz at the time, but Rory then sort of turned me on to people like Ornette Coleman, and we would try and inject the ideas into what we were doing. Controlled Abandon was heaven. It was just heaven. It's too much to bear.
I'm Gary Moore, and this is the Rory Gallagher story on BBC Radio 2, 88 to 91 FM. That's Rory on alto sax, by the way.
Rory at that time had a residency at the Marquee, and normally we would go every week and see him. And I was looking for my guitar sound. I wanted my guitar to sing. I wanted it to be a voice. And seeing this guy just blew me away. He really had the sound that I was looking for. beautiful beaten up old Stratocaster and his Vox AC30 and his treble booster. Treble booster is something very simple. It just boosts the signal, so whatever's coming out of the guitar becomes a bit louder before it gets into the amplifier. And in the marquee one night after he'd finished, I sort of hung around and was able to get chatting to him, and he was such a gracious man. I'm sure everybody tells you the same. The most gentlemanly person you could ever meet in this business, or any other business, probably. Such a sweet guy, you know, such a completely gentle and generous person with his time and everything. So these couple of kids come up, who's me and my mate, and say, you know, how do you get your sound, Mr. Gallagher? And he sits and tells us, and he says, well, Brian, you know, it's mainly this little box here, you know, a little Rangemaster treble booster. And I just plug my guitar in here, and the treble booster goes into the amp, and that's my sound. So I rushed straight out and got myself a Rangemaster and a couple of AC30s, second-hand, of course, and all beaten up, but they worked. And from that moment on, I had the sound that I wanted. I didn't have his guitar, I'd already made my own guitar, but my guitar just seemed to work perfectly in this setup. So I owe Rory my sound.
Very polite, shy, withdrawn sort of guy. And put the guitar around his neck, put him on stage, and vavoom, he turned into this other thing, this other being, which was great.